Hey guys, my name is Iasmina and welcome back to my channel. I make videos all about books, book recommendations, writing, and publishing your book, so if that sounds like something interesting to you, please consider clicking that subscribe button. In today's video, I want to show you how you can print your book without publishing it and how to order proof copies from Amazon KDP. So at the end of 2020, I ordered my first ever proof copy of my work in progress, Hunting Vienna, from Amazon KDP. And as you can see, it has a lovely not for resale banner. But in any case, it's a print book, it's a proper book, and it's beautiful. And I want to show you how I did that on Amazon KDP and how you can do it as well. But yeah, this will be an on-screen tutorial. So without further ado, let's get into the video.
Okay, so you will need a KDP Amazon account or just an Amazon account. So to order a proof copy, you have to go to kdp.amazon.com, and this is what that looks like. And then you need to sign in. And again, if you have an Amazon account, you can use that or you can make a separate KDP account. But I have an Amazon one, so let's sign in. And after you're signed in, this is what you see. This is your sort of home page, and you can see I have like two books here that I'm working on in different stages, but yeah, this is the one that I was telling you about. So you can create a ebook or a paperback, but in this case we want a print, so we're gonna click on paperback. And then you have a lot of inputs to fill out, so let's go through them. I'll speed this up because a lot of these are self-explanatory, but I'll go over the more important parts in more detail. Here you can add a series title, but in this case we'll just skip it. You can skip this as well. Okay, here you should pick I own the copyright, because assuming you've written it, it's yours. And then you don't need keywords, because again, you're just getting a proof copy and you don't need to fill out the categories. And here, of course, you know the content of your book, so make sure you pick the right one. Oh, okay. Apparently you do need a category. Fine. General fiction. Okay, now we go to the next page. There's a lot to fill out. Here you can just get a free ISBN. So with Amazon, you get a free ISBN when you publish with them, but you can also use your own. But for a proof copy, just get the free ISBN. So just click on assign and yeah, it'll just generate a random ISBN that will be unique for this proof copy of your book. Or of course, if you're actually going to publish it, it will work for that as well. And then you don't need to fill this out, just leave it blank. Now, print options. Here is where it gets more fun. For fiction, you usually want a black and white interior with cream paper. The cream paper makes it easier on the eyes to read. And to be honest, Amazon's cream paper is actually very white. So I don't know how the white is, but white, like pure white paper, is usually more used for nonfiction. So for fiction, I would recommend the cream paper. And then trim size, again, this will vary widely depending on what your preferences are, where you want to publish the book. But for me, what I did is I chose this trim size, 506 by 781 inches. This is a more UK paperback size that I personally prefer, because most of the books that I buy are in this size and that's what I prefer. But again, just go with what you want. Yeah, here you just want to stick to no bleed. And now here, the finish of the cover, you can choose from matte or glossy. And again, this is something that really depends on the genre of your book and just personal preference, really. Of course, you are just ordering a proof copy, so it really doesn't matter. Just pick whatever you want. But when you're actually publishing your book, it is actually quite important. So just look at the best-selling books in your genre and see what they do. Are their cover matte or are they glossy? And just go with that. And I think it also matters depending on the actual design of the cover, because some designs work better for glossy versus matte. Personally, I chose matte for my Hunting Vienna proof copy and I prefer matte. Just play around. You can order another one later on. You can order a matte now and then you can come back and change it to glossy and order a different one and just see what you prefer. So, and now Finally, you need your actual manuscript. This is where you need your actual book, so make sure you have that ready. It can be in multiple formats. As you can see here, I usually upload it as a PDF because I format it with Vellum, and Vellum gives you a PDF file to upload for your manuscript. So that's what I have, so that's what I'm gonna upload. If you wanna know how I formatted my manuscript, I will link a video up here and down in the description of how I did it using the Vellum software. And that's basically what I used to, yeah, create my book and my proof copy. So make sure you check that out if you're interested, but let's move on. So just pick your PDF or whichever format you have, and then it's gonna upload your actual manuscript. And this can take a little while depending on the file size. Okay, and then you need a cover. So for a proof copy, you don't really need to stress out if you don't have a book cover. You can actually have a cover made for you by their software. It's not gonna be very good, just FYI, but you know, if you don't care and you just want something, you can literally just follow their little editor here and, you know, make a cover right now. But if you already have a cover like I do, you know, just find it and upload it. Okay, and again, this is going to take some time to upload your file. And then it's going to process, so we can move on. And then what you want is to launch this preview and check that everything looks okay. So we're going to do that now, and this will take some time. This can take a few minutes, really, because they need to process your manuscript and your cover and make the final file that will then technically go to the printers. So this is quite an important step, so make sure you don't skip this, because otherwise you're going to have a really bad proof copy. You really need to make sure that everything looks in order, because I'm just going to say Amazon makes mistakes, and it's also up to you to check these things and make sure that everything looks fine before saving it and accepting it. Oh, here we go. Okay, finally, it's doing something. Hey, okay, that took a long time, but here is the actual print preview. So we need to make sure that everything looks right before we send it off to the printers, okay? And they're gonna show you some checks here, and if there are any issues, they will highlight them in red. I've already done this process, so I've already perfected it, so there's nothing in here right now, but there might be, and they will mention that here on the left-hand side. So you can check your cover, you know, you can zoom in and make sure that everything looks good. So the red lines mean that this is most likely where the printer will cut off the cover, and so you need to make sure all of your content is inside these red lines. So make sure your author name, you know, doesn't go beyond that, and the ISBN and all of that, all right? And then you can go into the actual manuscript and look through and make sure that everything is fine. Make sure that the text is within the boundaries and just go through the entire thing and make sure there's nothing weird going on. And then you also have like a thumbnail view to quickly jump to where you want to check things. But yeah, you can just go through this and make sure everything looks fine. And then if you're happy with it, you click approve. And if you're not happy with it and you want to change something, then you can just exit and re-upload your files and try again. But in this case, it's fine, so I'll just check approve. And here it will then actually show you how much it will cost to print your book. So this is just the print cost. And you can see the different prices on different Amazon domains. And they will actually let you choose which domain to order the print book from, so that you can have it cheaper, but then you do pay for the shipping on top of that as well. So then on the next page, there is more things to fill out, but the good news is that for a proof copy, you don't need to fill out anything more, because if you scroll down to here where it says request printed proofs of this book that you can order from the Amazon cart, this is what you need. Okay, so you need to click this link here and you'll get to this page, and here is where you can actually request the proof copies. So you can request up to 5 at a time, and as I mentioned, you can select which marketplace you want to order the print book from, and that'll just depend on the price. So on .com it costs $4.43, from Germany it costs 4.18 euros, so you know, just pick whichever one you want, but then don't forget that you will pay shipping on top of that. So even if it seems that it's cheaper from one place, it might not be with the shipping. And then, once you're happy with that, you just click Submit Proof Request. And then they will show you this pop-up, and it says that within 4 hours of submitting your request, you will get a link in your email. It's like a purchase link, and that will add the print book to your Amazon cart. And that's pretty much it. You will then have your print book in your cart, and then you can just order it like any other Amazon product. I'm not going to do that right now, so I'm just going to click cancel, but you would just confirm proof request and then wait for that email. You can also do this from your books section library. So you have your book here, and then where it says paperback actions, you can click these three dots, and you can also do it from here where it says request printed proofs, and it'll take you back to the same page. And that's it. And then once you add your book to your cart, it works just like any other Amazon product. And depending on your shipping time, you will have your new print proof copy of the book that you just wrote in your hands in a number of days, most likely. And it's really, really exciting. It's honestly such an exciting moment. And even though it's just a proof copy of a draft and it's not the finished thing, it still feels so cool and so exciting to actually hold your own words in your hand as an actual book. So I highly recommend doing this. It doesn't cost that much. It usually costs me around $10 to $15 to order this. So just like any other normal, you know, book that I would order. That is everything that I wanted to share. Please go and check out my other videos, and I have a little outro following now.
And there you have it. That's how I ordered my proof copy of my book from Amazon KDP, and how you can print your book without publishing it and have an actual book in your hands and to put on your shelves, which is very, very exciting. I will link down below and in the cards the video in which I received my proof and opened it and saw it for the first time if you're curious, because it was very exciting and it's still really exciting and fun just to have this on my desk and look at it and know that I wrote this book. It's still a work in progress, but yeah, it's super exciting. All right, that was it for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to like and subscribe. It really does help me out a lot. And otherwise, I will see you next time with a new video. Bye.